Hi, my name is Vanessa van Dijk, and in this video I want to share with you the safety of alpha arbutin and the potential risk of experiencing uneven dark patches or extremely uneven light patches. Now, I recently discovered a very interesting document which is fairly new, and it is from the European Commission. It's from the Scientific Committee on Consumer Safety, which questions the safety of alpha arbutin. This is where I want to keep my main focus on, and this document is from March 2022. So again, it is fairly new. I did highlight some of the most important points that I want to talk about and emphasize, as well as then lead into another potential problem why certain issues can arise. And they, to some extent, merge together based on the comments that I often receive under my alpha arbutin videos, which primarily are referring to ever since you were using alpha arbutin, you've either experienced uneven dark patches or extremely uneven light patches. And so I do hope that with this video right here, it puts some light onto the reason why this may have happened. And if you're thinking of getting alpha arbutin, then you may want to think about this twice. So let's look into this paragraph right here, which I have highlighted. So alpha arbutin is stable in vitro, so in laboratory, at 2% in a water-based solution and in cosmetic products for at least 3 months when the temperature is below 40 degrees. And the pH is between 4.5 and 7.5 under daylight. Now, I want you to remember that alpha arbutin is stable for at least 3 months when the temperature is below 40 degrees Celsius. Please remember this. This is going to be important. Alpha arbutin is not stable in the presence of the skin microbiome and enzymes, since it significantly leads to degradation, skin metabolism of alpha arbutin on the skin by enzymes and bacteria with the potential formation of hydroquinone. The latter could quickly disappear, possibly with a duct formation with cellular macromolecules. This could possibly play a role in adversity, in particular when chronic exposure occurs, which is the case for skin bleaching agents. So right here they are talking about that once you're going to apply alpha arbutin to the skin, it does not necessarily stay as alpha arbutin. It can potentially form into hydroquinone, which is a bleaching agent. Now, it can reverse it and then gets back into alpha arbutin, and then there shouldn't be an issue. However, if it's going to stay into hydroquinone, then this can cause a potential risk, because hydroquinone, you may already have heard of it, it is a bleaching agent that's primarily being used if you want to lighten dark patches, primarily known as to lighten dark patches if you experience melasma, liver spots, age spots, or even freckles. Now, if you're going to use hydroquinone, usually this is in some or in most countries banned, or if you can get it, it's usually only available if you see a doctor or dermatologist who then prescribes it to you and then gives you the specific directions on how you should use it because of the adverse effects that can occur and overall the controversy on hydroquinone itself. Because if you're going to use it the wrong way, if you're going to use it for a long period of time, it can potentially lead to unwanted skin lightening, which then would refer to extreme light uneven patches, which I have already read in some of my comments. So this is one potential risk that can occur. Now, the other one would be that additional human relevant data are necessary to exclude adversity due to the formation of hydroquinone and potentially benzoquinone by the skin microbiome and the skin metabolism. Now, I did not know what benzoquinone was, so I looked it up, and from my understanding, hydroquinone can turn into benzoquinone. Now, I just want to keep my focus towards benzoquinone and the safety part right here, which I got from the chemical book website. And benzoquinone is able to stain skin dark brown. So it can cause dark brownish patches. It can cause irritation, which then leads into redness and rashes, or it can even lead to cell death. Now, again, I'm not going to talk about cell death. I have no idea about this specific topic. I want to keep my focus towards irritation. So if you have used alpha arbutin, you had potential irritation while you were using it. This could be due to hydroquinone because it can have some irritation factors as well, or because it has turned hydroquinone into benzoquinone, and then again it could lead to redness and rushes. But the other most important point that I want to emphasize is that benzoquinone is able to stain the skin. That they do emphasize that it would be a stain, which would match up with the comments that I receive under my Alpha Arbutin videos. Because the most comments that I get is that you probably that you have experienced dark uneven brown patches, and while you have stopped using Alpha Arbutin, those dark uneven patches were decreasing. Now I'm not sure to what extent. However, it is interesting to know, because now based on the comments and based on what I'm reading right here, it's going to make sense that those dark brownish spots are potentially just stains. And then if you would stop using it, it's going to decrease. However, if you should experience extremely white light patches, then this is potentially due to hydroquinone, which the skin has turned into. But there is another risk, which I think plays a significant role as well, which is now my second part that I want to lead into, where the temperature plays a big role, as I already emphasized earlier. Since Alpha Arbutin, again, I want to repeat it, is stable for at least 3 months when the temperature is below 40 degrees. Now, while I was answering the comments, I always like to ask where you're from so that I have an idea of where those people are experiencing those issues. And it's interesting to me because usually it always refers to either you were from Asia or you were from Africa. And what connects to those places, it may happen in other countries as well, I'm not aware of, I'm just going to report what's most common based on the comments that I'm getting. What's interesting is that if you are looking into Western skincare companies and you want to get them towards Africa or you want to get them in Asia, usually they aren't that available. And if so, the shipping costs are quite high. So you are looking into a second retailer who is offering it at an affordable price so that you then can get those products. Now, what's interesting to me is that if you're getting those products by airplane, it shouldn't be an issue, other than the retailer, like the person who is going to sell those products to you, is storing it the wrong way. Then this may be one issue. But the other issue that I see with this is the potential shipment if your products are being shipped by a ship, because then the temperature may play a big role. And this is now where I want to lead into two studies that I found right here. The first one is this one, and they basically loaded and packed a container from New Jersey, which is in the USA, it's below New York, and sent it all the way to the Philippines, which again, it is an Asian part in the world, and it's quite hot and humid in that area as well. So the port transit time was about 60 days from one port to the other port. And so they shipped it in May. They do say that it was quite cool in May. And then they delivered it in the first week in July. And so right here is what they've documented during that time. So day three, they had about 43 degrees Fahrenheit, which is about 6 degrees Celsius. And then the last date that they had, it rose up to 95 degrees Fahrenheit, which is about 35 degrees Celsius. So right here, we are already pretty close to that 40 degrees mark where Alpha Arbutin can be destabilized. And so they do mention that, of course, during the recording, like with this device and how they recorded the temperature, that it was placed at the heart of the container, insulated by cartons, and the temperatures experienced closer to the walls, roof, and floors of the container were probably very much higher. So if you have a container, you put your package in the middle of it, and you are surrounding it with other products as well, with other packages as well, the temperature can change as if your package would be placed on the very top of the container. The same would apply to the entire container as well. So if your container is in the middle of the very bottom of the ship, it's probably much cooler as if it would be on the very top of the ship. Plus, is your container being cooled all the way through, or is it not cooled at all? And then due to the temperature itself that you have on the ocean, it can really rise and drop quite significantly. So that's one point. And I looked at another study as well, which came up with a similar uneven degrees due to the shipment. So again, they like recorded temperatures as low as minus 21 degrees Fahrenheit, which is about minus 29 degrees Celsius, which is pretty cold, and they've reached as high as 135 degrees Fahrenheit, which is about 57 degrees Celsius. So there we have already basically knocked out the 40 degrees where Alpha Arbutin is going to be stable. Now let's imagine that your order comes by ship, and it is pretty hot during your season, and it has been in a package in a container for, let's say, maximum a week, I don't know, maybe a few days, and with the current situation even longer, then of course the longer it becomes like hot, the longer it sits in higher temperatures that are above 40 degrees, of course the more likely your alpha butin is going to destabilize. And so this may also raise some significant questions that if you're going to receive a product, in this case alpha butin, that has already destabilized while you were like shipping it to your country, to your place, and depending also on how the retailer was storing it, of course this can then, once you get it in your own hands to use it on the skin, it has already destabilized, and it potentially then again can lead to a hydroquinone, which has potentially already formed while it destabilized, then already in the formulation itself. So when then applying it to the skin, you can erase certain skin issues, not only irritation, but maybe again the like stained brown spots, or even the lightening spots, which then look extremely uneven. And this has all happened just as you started using alpha butin. So then of course the root cause of this is potentially alpha butin. Now, there are two major reasons why this can happen. It's either your skin that has done this, or because alpha arbutin was already destabilized due to the shipment and the storage of the product itself. So there are still significant questions that are open to me, but I do want to point the major points out that I did notice in my comments, and I do hope that with this information you can already get the idea that depending on where you live, depending if you can get the product directly from the company or if you have to get it from a retailer, then I recommend thinking about this twice. You then want to potentially look into a different lightening ingredient other than alpha butin, because there are other ones available as well, but in this specific case this can bring up a significant risk to the skin itself. Now there's one last point that I do want to emphasize, which is right here on the document itself again, where they basically put out the question, what would be this, is there any safety concentration, or is there any data that provides the safety of how you would use alpha butin? So it basically mentions that having considered the data provided and other relevant information available in the scientific literature, the SCCS cannot conclude on the safety of alpha butin when used in face creams up to a maximum concentration of 2%. And in body lotions up to a maximum concentration of 0.5%. Relevant data on the degradation metabolism of alpha butin exposed to the skin microbiome enzyme are not available, and the release of hydroquinone and its final fate are not documented. These data are essentially required for safety assessments. For this reason, given under question 1, the SCCS cannot recommend a safe concentration of alpha butin. So overall, because the data is missing of what exactly is happening when applying alpha butin to the skin and how the skin is going to use alpha butin, if it stays into alpha butin or if it's turning it into hydroquinone or potentially benzoquinone, this is basically where the safety is still at risk, because it is not known what's exactly going to happen and to what percentage it's going to happen. Because hydroquinone in so many countries is basically banned or significantly restricted on how you should use it and for how long you should be using it. This is also an important point. So I do hope that with that information I'm just giving you, based on what I have highlighted, based on what I want to emphasize in this video, what can potentially go wrong when using an alpha butin product, not only if you can get it like this from the counter and you know that it's from the company itself, or if it's going to be shipped to your country because you aren't getting it right away, there are significant risks that you have to keep in mind. So overall, If you live in a such country, as already pointed out earlier, in Asia or even in Africa, you may want to think about ordering an alpha arbutin like product twice, and then maybe just consider looking into another lightening product instead that you can get on hand like in your country itself. Now I'm going to put all the data, like all the links, the documents in description box down below. If you want to read it in your own time, you can go ahead and do so. But this is where I want to keep my focus on. I do hope that I could put some light onto those specific concerns and I could help you out a bit further. Now, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, if you find it helpful, please don't forget to give the thumbs up as well as share it. And I will see you soon in the next one. Happy skin caring. Bye.